Previously on Survivor, the Alliance of Six successfully voted out Kelly, and in doing so, blindsided the pair of Brooke and Alex. Despite seemingly being on the bottom, multiple players reassured Brooke and Alex that there was still hope. But when Jake informed Alex that the vote towards her during the revote was from Brooke, Alex began to consider the option of abandoning ship and seeking out a new alliance. The next immunity challenge took place at Campbell Hall, of which is also the location of the yet-to-be-found South Campus Idol. This challenge was touchy subjects, where the players' true perceptions of one another were brought to light. In the end, it was Greg who was able to outlast the rest, beating out Allison to win individual immunity. In addition, host Greg had informed the cast that someone was to receive a secret advantage as a result of something that happened in the challenge. As it turns out, player Greg was selected to be its recipient. The advantage was a never-before-seen power called the Invisibility Advantage, awarded to Greg as a result of being answered the most out of anyone on everyone's surveys, and thus being perceived as the most visible player remaining in the final eight. Immediately following the challenge, Brooke planted the seeds to attempt to eliminate Stephanie. But sensing this plan had no traction, Alex had a different agenda, wanting to vote out Brooke instead. With the Brooke plan on the table, many players started a plan for the impending civil war within the Alliance of Six. Using information he received from Alex, Jake tried to rope in Stephanie alongside himself and Autumn, in an attempt to combat what appeared to be a three of Greg, Ryan, and Allison. Meanwhile, Greg revealed that he had won the advantage to Allison, and the powerful duo alluded to a plot to actually target Ryan at seven, by capitalizing on Allison's relationship with Autumn. After fall break, Autumn found herself at a crossroads, unsure whether to put her trust in the likes of Greg and Ryan, or her blossoming alliance with Jake and her roommate Stephanie. However, with tribal quickly approaching, the focus reshifted to the upcoming vote. As expected, Brooke attempted to rally up the numbers to target Stephanie, not knowing that her perceived closest alliance in Alex was actively plotting against her. A plan was then hatched to split votes 5-3 amongst Stephanie and Brooke, in case of an idol or advantage being played. Despite being aligned with Stephanie, Jake chose to cast his vote in Stephanie's direction alongside Alex. In reality, both were still in on the plan to eliminate Brooke, and this was exactly what happened. In a 5-3 vote, Brooke was the one voted out in 8th place, joining her best friend Kelly on the jury bench. From the outside looking in, the logical next move would be to target Alex, the last remaining member of Kelly's original alliance. But the Six is very obviously divided, and this could be the week where a big move is made. Tonight, find out who will join Brooke and Kelly on the jury, and who will maneuver their way into a spot in the final six.
Pretty straightforward, like I thought it was going to be. I mean, we've had that plan to take out Kelly and then Brooke for, I don't know, a couple weeks now, basically since the merge.
Everything went to plan. Brooke ended up going home, and I really didn't want Greg to read the third Steph vote, because now I'm going to have to do some explaining to Steph, because she doesn't know about us getting Jake to vote for her, so I'll have to fill her in or just try and lie to her and say, I don't know who flipped. If we can all keep up that lie, that would be nice.
But moving forward, I don't know, Greg's last words at the end made me nervous. Like, he says, yeah, from here on out, the game's just going to get faster and it's going to get harder. Like, yeah, I feel like that stress coming on.
Now it gets fun, because I don't really know who our next target is. I kind of think I'm going to be a target at 7, which is nerve-wracking, so hopefully I can win the challenge again tomorrow. And wear this again for another week would be pretty dope.
So I'm definitely concerned about next week and what will happen there, because I think there's a big target on my back, especially after this vote.
I know that Ryan and I need to talk and see what he's thinking, because we haven't really gone super in-depth about 7 yet, but we kind of all know that something is going to happen at 7 that's not straightforward.
Moving forward, No. We're good. Me and Greg and Autumn were discussing targeting Ryan coming up next because he is a big threat and we don't think he would see it coming. But that's just stressful because he is a good player and he's somebody that, you know, I really have grown to like and like enjoy being around. So that's going to be hard.
So it'll definitely be a very scary week during travel next week.
Hello, hello. We're here.
It's lunchtime.
It's lunchtime for some. So I had a conversation with Brooke today. I think it went pretty well, you know. I think it's her going home tonight, to the best of my knowledge, so. You know, boop boop, bye bye.
Like I told you, I'd like try to like let you know how things were going, and from what I'm like from what I've been told, at least like people are putting focus on Stephanie, and I think that's who they're telling me to vote tonight. So that's who I'm assuming I'm voting tonight. You know what I'm saying? So like,
yeah,
unless they do some crazy plan. For.
She says she's voting Stephanie. I think I'm voting Stephanie. So she can't get mad at me. I voted with her, you know. Then I met with Stephanie. I filled her in because I think it's good to get her trust.
The basics that you need to know is that you are getting votes. What they want to do is they want me to vote you tonight as well. Like Ryan told me yesterday when I met him to vote
shitty?
You.
What?
And Greg told me to do that today too. So it's still.
Why do they want to pit us against each other?
The thing is, everyone else is still voting Brooke. So this is going to be scary in case Brooke has an idol today, but I met with her today. I don't think she does. I want you to know that like you're getting two votes, potentially three, and that's why I want to ask, would you care if I put your name down? Because it's not going
to
change.
No, because we can use that to our advantage.
Yeah. Okay.
Even if Brooke has an extra vote or she can steal a vote, it doesn't matter. It's still going to be Brooke, right?
Right. That's what I'm thinking.
So I filled her in on the plan, and I wanted to get her approval to put her name down, because I'd put her name down in the past. Didn't ask that time. But this time I thought it'd be a good idea to let her know, and I think she also saw that it was a good plan because it separates me and her even more, so no one can picture us working together. So
I'm not one to say write my name, but I think in this case, if they're really being genuine that they want Brooke on, which I think that they are, so I think it's beneficial for them to think that we hate each other.
And like, I just want to be clear with you, okay. I'll make sure you know it's me because I'm gonna do the like fifth grade like S. You know, like,
you're gonna do the Superman S.
Superman S. So
okay.
That way you'll
okay.
know it's me.
So onto this tribal council, I will be putting Stephanie's name down unless something crazy happens. It makes sense. It separates us. No one will know that we're working together, and we can make a good move the next vote. And hopefully, Brooke will just go home.
The 9-person voted out. Subscriber time and change. And the second member of our jury, Brooke. Sorry. Grab the torch.
Okay, so that vote went pretty good, I thought. I'm hoping that through this vote, I've set myself up with the right people, but I feel bad for little Brookie. I can tell she was a little sad. I'm, like, nervous for the challenge tomorrow. Honestly, I think, like, I'm nervous. Like, I don't think this is going to happen, but I'm nervous there's going to be, like, a tribal council right after. So I definitely want to meet with at least Alex tomorrow so I can, like, say, like, I have a proposed alliance for us.
I met with Stephanie right before this last vote. I told her everything that was going on. She knew that you were putting your name down too, and I was putting your name down. She knew it was not of our own accord.
Yeah.
She and I both came to the conclusion that we should try to make like a group of four for when we get to seven.
It's been an interesting day. I met with Jake earlier, and pretty much like the ideal thing that could have possibly happened because I've been thinking about how it's really time to start finding a group again or forming a group because like now's the time people are going to start talking about final four, final three, who they want to take all the way with them. So when Jake approached me today with a plan, it was just kind of ideal.
I'm close to you, I'm close to Stephanie, and I'm close to Autumn.
So I met with Alex today, it went great. Every meeting with Alex feels great. She seemed really on board to go with the plan, and I filled her in on like my relationships with Autumn. In relation to that, Autumn, you know you're my rock out here. You know I'm a paranoid person. You know I can come to you and you'll say, you need to calm down. I'm glad to have you with me. Okay, so I didn't go into like as much detail about how close Autumn and I actually are. Like we're letting Alex know so she trusts us more, but like, we're not telling her, like, it's going to be final two. Read him and weep. So.
And so we, like, agreed on, like, that's a good four. Like, we trust that four.
I'm feeling really good about this alliance of four. I think it has potential to be really great. I told her, I was like, I don't think people know how much we trust each other. I don't think people know Autumn and Stephanie, how close they are, how close I am with Stephanie or Stephanie, whatever. Like, we're all interconnected, but no one really knows. I don't like to get too long-term because I'm already paranoid enough about the present. If I start incorporating the future into that, I would be a mess. But I honestly could see it getting taken to the final four.
So you can meet with them, obviously, to, like, reassure, but, like, that's a four that could, like, could be final four. And, like, I trust you more than anyone else, so, like, yeah, I would honestly be fine taking you to the end.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want to, like...
I am, of course, wary of Stephanie, and I do think she could possibly flip, but I also think that she knows that she's not Ryan's closest alliance anymore. It's kind of Ryan and Greg. They have all the power in the game right now, as evidenced by the last tribal council, where they pretty much had their say, regardless of whether I agreed with whether I wanted that decision to happen or not, which, like, I did. But it still just, like, shows how powerful they really are. So it'd be great to see one of them go home this week.
I agree that Stephanie's kind of a wild card right now. I think she will go with us this week. She understands how the game is turning and how all the power is with Greg and Ryan.
I also told Alex how Autumn and I have been working with Stephanie, you know, let her know, like, Stephanie needs to think she's in control, and that's the safest way to make it happen, is to act like we're number ones, like, act like we trust her more than anyone else. But hopefully Alex, even if Stephanie's just going crazy, Alex would trust me and Autumn enough to know, like, we like you more than Stephanie, we'll keep you longer than Stephanie, like, let's work with her for a week at least, so.
I think she might throw some of the bus. But I think a way we could prevent that is just making her feel like she's in control and making all the decisions. Something you need to do, I think, is, like, really make sure that she feels like you're one of her number, like, high up there. Like, you could be her number one.
Yeah. So where's your head at and your thoughts and everything that happened?
Okay. Also wanted to clear the air again because I had to put your name down, but I was, like, strong-handed into doing that, basically, because I did want Brooke out. Sure, like, lo and behold, Ryan came in with a plan, like, this entire thing that him and Greg had worked out, and I'm just like, okay. I'm sorry that you have your name worked out. Like, I know that's very stressful.
Last night was tribal council, and it was Brooke and not me, which made me really happy. I did get 3 votes, which came from Brooke, Alex, and Jake. I, like, confirmed with Jake that he should write my name down, and now looking back, I said that for the wrong reasons, because I was thinking that, like, Ryan was trying to pin us against each other and hate us, but I think they were actually trying to save themselves in case Brooke did have an idol and wanted to get, like, Greg or Ryan out. Like, it couldn't have been, like, a 7-1, so Alex and Jake both put my name down. So it would have been me going home and not one of them. But I'm here regardless, so...
Like, how I'm seeing it, like, right now, like, I see Greg, Ryan, and Allison as a strong 3.
Yeah, and they
then you, me, Jake, and Autumn, who, like, don't have that, like, strong thing going on like they do.
People see Greg, Ryan, and Allison as being a really good trio, and then there's the remaining 4 who are kind of like individual people at this point in the game. So I met up with Alex. You know, I sparked in her head working closely together, like, let's start, you know, voting the same way, then working with Jake and Autumn. I think that'd be a really good group of 4. We would have the majority.
You know, for my game plan in my head, I'm thinking the 4 of us build something really, really strong.
I think it's good
because from what I hear, Greg wants to get Ryan out at 7 and Ryan wants to get Greg out at 7.
For the next vote after this one, I just wanted to see what your thoughts were because I kind of am hoping to make a big move next vote.
I've started to think into the next vote because I kind of want to make a move at 7 that kind of changes the game. This week, I have, like, kind of a plan that I've been thinking of. I'm going to try and get Greg out this week. I don't know why Greg still has yet to receive a vote. Like, he's just so, like, everyone thinks they need him when really they don't. Like, we can all work together to get him out. Even though I have so much trust in him, like, he needs to go now. Right now is where he needs to go because that's the only time that we can get him.
Even if you trust him, like, I trust him. Like, I trust him a lot because we've been, like, working together. But, like, he's literally has the game set in his hands.
Yeah, and I'm not going to lie. It's been said that Greg wants you out of 7. I think I'm in a good spot where my name won't be thrown out this week. I'm pretty sure Greg wants to get Ryan and Ryan wants to get Greg.
Okay, well, so they're going to be running to the 4 of us.
Yeah, and we can just, like, go with whatever they're saying.
And we can decide what we want to do and, like, which one we want to get out. Gosh.
So my name's not out there, which makes me really, really happy. And I have options, you know, depending on who wins tonight. If Greg does, we have Ryan. If Ryan does, we have Greg. And hopefully one of the stronger threats will go home.
If Greg wins, we'll probably maybe try to go for Ryan. If Ryan wins, maybe try to go for Greg. But hopefully neither of them win. We have options. Okay.
Hey.
Hello.
Hello.
And I'm not talking about that chicken from Moana.
The more I think about it, a lot of people are talking about getting Greg and Ryan out this week, and I agree with it.
Like me and Autumn have been doing for a little while. Kind of how we've been doing for a little while, too, and how you and Stephanie have been. Like, everyone's kind of like, this alliance is perfectly under wraps. People don't think you guys are close. Like, this is awesome.
Yeah. I'm kind of leaning towards Ryan, but Greg is super manipulative, so I don't really care. As long as Greg or Ryan do not win this challenge, I think that they're going to be trying so hard today because obviously they both know that their names are on the line.
I want this to be like the main three. Like, I want Stephanie to think like the main three is me, her, Autumn. She might think like you're her closest ally.
I don't really know what's going to happen when we do get to Final Four, Final Three, if I'm with Stephanie and Jake and Alex. But I'm very excited. I feel like I'm with a really good group. For the most part, I feel like we're kind of keeping it under the radar.
We need a nickname. We'll nickname in the works. I don't
know
why.
The Misfits earlier.
The Misfits.
That could work.
Yeah, we got the
Misfits.
Pretty good. So wish me luck in this challenge. So excited, and I feel like I'm gonna win today. So we'll see.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to another individual immunity challenge. Before I get to explaining what it is, Greg, I'm sorry. Bring it on up. All right. Once again, individual immunity is back up for grabs. Each one of you will have a bucket. They're adjusted to your height. And attached to the bucket is a rope. That rope has little strings tied to it at different intervals. You will start holding the rope with your feet in place, leaning backwards. In 5-minute intervals, you will move one hand below the other every 5 minutes until you're holding more and more rope and leaning further and further back. So once you guys move your hands 5 times, we're gonna hold there until we have a winner. The last person standing will win individual immunity. It's a very simple challenge, but it's gonna test you. I'm excited. You guys look pumped. So with that, we're gonna give you guys a couple minutes to get in your spots and everything. We'll adjust for heights and get started, all right?
All right, so with that, I'm gonna count you guys in. You're closest to the fence on this one, sandwiching that first knot. And your time starts now. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's gonna be easy at first, and then it starts getting harder every 5 minutes.
Greg's got such a serious face right now.
Finding my happy place.
I'm not in the mood for small talk. I'm here to win. Alex.
1 minute in.
Needed to make out.
Let's go.
Small talk. Talk about your break.
Oh, yeah, wait. Ryan, how was Canada?
It was fun.
Did you, like, lose a bunch of money?
Yeah.
Go figure.
Unfortunately.
2 minutes.
We're almost halfway done with this first stage.
It's great.
And then it just gets worse.
You're lucky we bought a thicker rope. Everyone doing all right?
Jake, how are you hanging down there?
Not well, Greg, not well.
Once we get to 5, I will count you in. You have 5 seconds to transition your top hand below your bottom hand.
This is fun. Every moment of my life is already pain. Sorry, Alex is a nurse. If one of us dies, Alex legally has to also let go.
Hi, guys. You've officially reached 5 minutes. You'll have 5 seconds on my go to move your top hand to your bottom. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You should have both hands between the first two knots. All right, guys, we are 1 minute in.
Oh,
That first minute was a lot longer than the last first minute.
If it makes you feel any better, you guys have already lasted longer than the endurance challenge from last season. And it's only been 6 minutes.
We've already beat it.
I'm sorry.
Guys, we're about 2 minutes, 20 seconds into the second round here. And if you're hurting already, and you want a little reward for what you're doing, you can have this. Whatever this is, you can have it. It's great.
I'll take it, Gregory.
You want it, Jake?
Can I?
If you like it, just let go.
That's all I have to do?
That's all you have to do. Jake is out of this challenge. Jake, accepting temptation.
Knowing Greg, it's going to be like a rock.
Yeah, probably.
Jake gets a scoop of mashed potatoes.
Nice!
Living life.
Nice cold mashed potato scoop.
Enjoy your time over there, kid.
Hey, careful flailing that around.
What?
Jake is out of this challenge. We are down to six. We're now at 10 minutes. On my go, you'll have 5 seconds to start to transition to the next stage. Go! 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You guys have started the third stage. You should be sandwiching the second knot. 1 minute in.
It's getting cold. Tired.
Alex looks like she's showing off with one hand. Either that or she's just trying to rest it.
It's the rest.
We're almost at 4 minutes. Almost. Still six strong.
Strong. Six, though.
You guys are at 5 minutes. You guys will be moving that top hand down in between the second and the third knot. Go! 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stephanie drops out, didn't even see it.
Oh, shit.
Stephanie is out of this challenge. We're down to 5. And with that, we're into the fourth round. So, you like what you saw with Jake? You want this one, you can come get it. Don't think you're gonna win. You want it? Come and get it. You guys have 15 seconds if you want it, otherwise I'm putting it away for good. 10 more seconds. No one wants it. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. How about now? Does anyone want it now?
Shit.
I don't know. What is it?
Those aren't potatoes.
No clue. Not mashed potatoes. But if you want it, drop out. Maybe you don't need immunity. If you want it, tell me, because you got about 2 more minutes to declare it. Do I need to walk over to the other side and let you sniff it?
Yeah.
Probably smells better.
Yes. Can I just get a closer?
Probably smells better than the mashed potatoes. But I'm just going to... You want it, just tell me. It's right here.
Can I take a smell of it?
After this, you guys will be on the last knot in between your hands. And we're gonna go there now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. You lost your chance. That's fine.
Just think, after this round, 25 minutes, you will have been in this round. And we still have one more round.
I'll tell you what I didn't expect, was to see 5 of you.
We're pretty tough.
So either you guys are pretty tough, or you're all just really nervous.
Can it be both?
Could it be both? All right. I'm just going to give you a warning. When we get to the last round, I want both hands up. Not right now, but if you all make it, I want both. We are now entering the last round. You guys have 5 seconds to transition. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we're going to stay here until someone wins immunity. Arms above your head, 2 arms on the whole time. Ryan is out of this challenge. We're down to 4. Just like that.
I'm really lonely down here. Oh, I can see Autumn. Hey, what's up?
Hey, girl, hey. What's going on down there?
Oh, you know, just hanging.
Literally.
It was a joke.
I have a proposition. A deal. I'm going to put 20 seconds on the clock. And if one of you doesn't want it for yourself, I can just let y'all read it as a group over here, these three. That 20 seconds starts now. You want it for yourself? You want it for the group? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That was easy. Congrats, guys. Now, so, none of you wanted it. It's up to them what they do with it. And I've got no other offers on the table except immunity. So, one of you will take it, three of you will walk away empty-handed.
Yes, I'm ready.
South 13. This is the third of many clues that lead you to this spot. You struggle to find this idol, but through this clue, you should not. The difference between this game and Survivor on TV, you don't have to be at camp to ring the bell of victory.
See, like, I went out after because I didn't want to get the target on my back of having the clue, and now I have the clue.
I know.
The pain is fueling me.
The pain you feel. Hey, you want to get rid of it?
No!
Someone's going to sleep easy tonight. The rest of you are just going to be sore as fuck. It's a lot to have you over here. Look at us. Join us.
Is The Exorcist the movie where her head turns backwards? Because that would be very useful right now.
Both of you have already worn this before.
Yeah, it's pretty nice.
I want it back.
Allison, you haven't worn it yet?
No, and I like fine
you
jewelry.
Want to touch it?
Yeah. Here.
All you have to do is
here.
Take a hand off.
No.
Allison, it's not that great. You don't want it.
Thanks, Autumn.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah. I think we've had a really nice endurance challenge, and I think I want to end it the way we started. Everyone, repeat after me. I want your arms straight, facing where you were when you started. 3, 2, 1.
Your face should be parallel to the fence. If you twist, if your rope goes slack, if you turn your body at all, you will be eliminated.
Am I coming down?
You might slack your rope, buddy.
Slack my rope?
Oh, I see what you're saying. Sorry.
Alex, straight. Fence.
Slack your rope, buddy. Alex out of the challenge.
Oh my god, my back. That feels good to
bend
over.
We're down to three. Autumn, Greg, and Allison.
Oh.
Allison's out of this challenge. Greg and Autumn.
That probably looks like I have to pee really bad. This is such an awkward position. Oh! Allison.
Huh?
I didn't know Allison dropped.
Yeah.
Like a rope.
Is it directed at me?
It goes again, I'm calling.
Okay.
Greg, stay straight. Greg hanging on by a finger. Slack. The rope's slacking,
oh.
Buddy. I'm gonna call that. I'm sorry.
Yep.
With that, Autumn wins individual immunity.
Oh my god, I can't breathe.
Long night.
Yes.
We're up there for an hour. I'm not gonna make a move. Autumn.
Oh, thank god.
Congratulations on winning your second individual immunity. Guaranteed a spot in the final six. The rest of you, one of you will be going home and the third member of the jury. Get a good night's sleep. Good night.
So,
second time. Honestly, I don't know why I held in there that long. Didn't really need this week. I don't know. I guess pride got in the way. Once Allison and Alex dropped out, it was kind of just me and Greg. And I know that either Greg or Ryan is most likely going to go home this week. And I wanted to have our options open. So I did it for everyone else in this game. This is not for me. It was just so Greg couldn't have it. I always tell myself before I come to a challenge like Autumn, maybe you shouldn't try as hard in this one because people are going to see you as a challenge threat, which I never thought I would say because if you look at me, I look like a potato. Like, I'm not that athletic. I don't know. I know that there's some people that can say, okay, I'm throwing this challenge, but it's just not a part of me. I can't do it. I'm very competitive. 2 out of 3. Hopefully, I'm going to win a lot more after this.
I mean, I don't even have words. That's just frustrating because I was up there for what, like 50 minutes or whatever. Props to Autumn. That was awesome. I'm glad that she got it, but I wish I would have had it because I really felt like my name is going to get brought up, and so I was really thinking I might need the necklace, but it's cool. Hopefully I can make sure I've got 4 people with me. I know I have Allison. Myself is 2. I really think I have Autumn as 3, and we just need to find a 4th, I guess, and I think we could get Jake or Alex, and if I feel like I'm in trouble, I've got my advantage. Deep down, I don't think I need to use it, but at the same time, I know if Ryan's name is going to get brought up, so is mine. Either of us are pretty attractive options to take out here, because you can easily go to people and say, hey, final 4, let's take out somebody, and then roll with it, so.
All right, so Autumn won that challenge, which I'm pretty happy about, because it wasn't Greg. Didn't want him to win the challenge at all, so I was getting a little nervous there at the end, but I'm glad that she won and not him, and now I have to see what she's thinking, which it looked like they were kind of talking around and like joking during that challenge. That kind of scares me a little bit on what their plans are.
I'm definitely going to reach out to Autumn and Alex and Greg and try to solidify some sort of plan, because I know me, Greg, and Autumn have one idea for how we wanted this vote to go. Ryan was on our minds, but now that he got that advantage, I'm going to try to meet with Jake because he also read it. I think he would be willing to work with us to get out Ryan, but I just want to know what that advantage that Idol Clue said.
I almost dropped out for the immunity thing, but then Greg said that the 3 people sitting down would get to know it, and I'm really close with Jake and Steph. I don't know if Jake's going to tell me, but Steph, sure. I'm going to be walking home with Steph, and she's going to tell me what it was, and we're probably going to go look for it.
Let me read it to you lovely folks, because just in case, the part that's important. You don't have to be at camp to ring the bell of victory. So there's a tradition here at Ohio State. Former member of Residence Life. There is a tradition here. Every time we win, there's a victory bell that rings. It's decided by Ryan, Stephanie, and myself that we are going to wait to reveal it till tomorrow so that we have the night to look for it. The problem is, it's like right there. And there's no subtle way to go look for it anytime soon, but I don't want to wait until Ryan finds it. So, I've got some things to think about. I'm picturing myself just running to the side and running and grabbing it before anyone notices I'm even gone. It's literally feet away from where we were during this challenge. This is going to be an awkward run, but I'm going to run.
I got to find that idol.
I've been walking around with this clue. It looks like a little joint. Whenever student services drives by, they get a little treat.
All right, so it's your boy, the perennial powerhouse in challenges, who is expected to win every single challenge. And we've had 3, and I haven't came close to winning one of them. We're out here starting the idol hunt. Threw on some flannel lined khakis by Eddie Bauer. Give me a shout out if you want, guys.
Luckily, I have the hidden immunity idol clue. I would love to find it because I know my head's gonna be on the chopping block this week. I think that if I find the immunity idol and then can kind of get Autumn, Steph, and hopefully I was thinking Alex on board with it, that I think we can go along with the plan to get Greg out, which would be kind of crazy. I think I'm not in the best shape, but I definitely could be in a lot worse shape.
We're out here headed to actually where the challenge just was, Ohio Stadium.
All right, so me and Steph are here.
Yes.
And look what's above us. Right there.
Got it? Yep.
Right there is the Bell of Victory.
Okay, so today was a huge physical challenge. I have 0 arm strength. I ended up making it to round 3, and then I said, okay, like, that's enough. And obviously, like, I'm really glad that I made that decision because I got out and got the idol clue. Me, Ryan, and Jake know. I would tell Autumn because she's my roomie and I love her, but hopefully we find it tonight.
I also think all 3 clues are
connected. Because oh, yeah. A, he sounds hella pissed. He's like, you're so dumb. Why haven't you found it? This is your third clue. And then B, my first clue that I found said it was in a tree somewhere on yeah. Southwest. And then the second one said it was in an alcove. By
I don't know what an alcove is, but this looks
neither.
Like an alcove,
yeah,
maybe.
Yeah, I would say so. And then it said, like, somewhere you would go to work out, and if you're driving here.
The RPAC is right there. And we should find this.
I'm super pumped for Autumn. Like, I knew she had that, like, going against Greg. But now that neither Greg or Ryan have the immunity necklace, that gives us good options coming in for this next week. Right now, I think me, Jake, Autumn and Alex are going to try and form an alliance of four. So I'm pumped. I hope we find this idol. Good job, Autumn. Greg put in a mental challenge because I'm good at those.
We'll check back in with you if we find anything or when we don't find anything, which is more likely.
This feels very stupid because I checked every freaking nook and cranny by this stupid victory bell. Screw traditions. I want answers. This is Jake formally resigning from Idol Hunt. Post challenge, whatever.
Jake's a wimp. He's tapping out early.
Well, I mean, you saw my challenge performance.
Uncommitted
to the end.
All right, we're checking back in. Jake left a while ago, but we're still in the shadow of the victory bell, and did not give us victory.
No.
It gave us defeat. Calling it quits here.
Bye.
See you guys.
What's up? So the day after the challenge that Autumn won, I met with Allison.
Basically, I just had a meeting with Jake, and obviously he starts off by saying whatever clue they found. You had the right idea because I was holding that goddamn rope for 50 minutes and got nothing out of it, and you held it for like a few minutes and got potatoes and a clue.
So the clue, yes, I will tell you about that. So what Ryan, Stephanie, and I basically decided was like we were gonna take the night to look for it for ourselves, and then we tell anyone we wanted to the next day.
He said that Ryan and Steph and him basically decided, hey, we're just gonna keep this clue to ourselves for tonight and then tell people tomorrow because people are gonna know we have it.
So basically the clue was the third clue to the South Campus Idol, and it just said that it was hidden by the victory bell.
And surprisingly, it had nothing to do with the Merge Idol. It actually was the South Campus one from like the very beginning.
Yeah.
Apparently there's some sort of belt near the RPAC, so that makes sense with the last clue. And then he said he went out to look for it, obviously, that last night, and ran into both of them looking for it too.
Me, Stephanie, and Ryan all ran into each other looking for it last night.
Oh.
I gave up searching after probably like 40 minutes. I was like...
And so it's kind of obvious, you know, that none of them have an idol if they're all looking. And then he was quick to ask me about my opinion for the vote.
Moving on to bigger, better news. So what do you guys, or what are you thinking this week? Because I feel good about the original Orla Peary. Like,
mm-hmm.
I don't distrust Alex at all. I think it should be Ryan or Stephanie this week, personally. I don't have,
yeah,
like, a
okay.
personal preference.
I'm glad you said that, because I'd be fine with that, too.
Yep.
And basically, he's like, well, I'm thinking I'd be fine with Stephanie or Ryan. And I was like, I know that, you know, between Ryan and Stephanie, I feel like Stephanie's closest with Autumn and Ryan, whereas, like, Ryan's close with most everybody. Like, he's really close with Greg.
Not me, though. No. He hasn't made that.
He's close with Autumn, but, like, he's friendly enough. So.
Both him and Greg are very good social players.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Greg is just a little more personable, and, like, I trust Greg more. But that just might be because I voted with him more.
Stephanie only seems to be working with Ryan, and she seems to get along with Autumn, whereas Ryan is more of a threat, and he gets along with everybody, and he's been working with a lot more people. And Jake's like, yeah, I agree. I just didn't want to be the one to say it. I don't want to be too bold.
I'm fine with it. Like, I think it works for us. We can just vote the other one out the next week. And
exactly,
like,
exactly. And hearing you say that Ryan was looking makes me think he doesn't have an idol. Why would he be out there looking? So it sounds like he's, you know, on board to get out Ryan.
Pretty much the meeting with Allison, she had met with Jake and, you know, had kind of just brought up, oh, well, you know, Greg and Ryan are threats. And Jake was a lot more on board with voting out Ryan, according to Allison, which is awesome, because I also kind of want to vote out Ryan this vote. I mean, I don't want to, but I think it's the best play. You don't win the game by making friends and keeping them to the end. You win the game by taking out threats and playing the best game, and I think this would be a very big move. It doesn't take a genius to realize that at 7, it's a good opportunity to make a move, and Ryan and I are definitely the two biggest targets and biggest threats in the game. You know, both of us are exposed because we didn't win immunity, so it just makes sense that they would want to target one of us, and obviously I don't want it to be me. I know that Allison wants to vote out Ryan. Steph, there's no way she will. I mean, Ryan's her closest ally, but if we've got Jake on board, I know that Autumn has said in the past that she would potentially be on board, and so to hear that Jake told Allison that he's on board, I mean, right there, that's four with me, Allison, Jake, and Autumn. And I know that Allison and Alex are getting closer, and so that's a potential fifth, and we just leave Ryan and Steph in the dark then.
I'm feeling good about this vote. Definitely better than at the end of this challenge.
Yeah, that's a breath of fresh air. Mm-hmm. So then do you want to try to potentially go to Jake and Alex and be like, hey, final four?
Yeah, I mean, I think that would be a good four.
Because
yeah.
Like Autumn, if Autumn's at final four, she's going to be dangerous.
Yeah.
My ideal final four would be Allison, Jake, and Alex, I think. I think I would like to take Autumn out at five, and then that leaves me in a pretty good spot to win, or at least make a run at winning. I mean, I think I would have the best game at that point, but I mean, that's way in the future.
Ryan this vote, Steph or Autumn next vote, and probably
and then Steph or Autumn with the next one, yeah. Basically, Ryan, Steph, and Autumn be the next three. Yeah.
Not hopeless, for sure. I thought it was a pretty much a 50-50 shot between me and Ryan, so if I can start pushing Ryan's name, then I'm good, so we'll see.
I like it.
All right.
Cool.
Good.
Sweet.
It is after the challenge. There was kind of a lot of stuff that went down.
So it was me, Jake, and Ryan who received the clue to the idol, and it basically told us that it's going to be by the victory bell. I quickly left Autumn. I told Autumn immediately after. I was like, here's the clue. Like, I have to go look for it.
Basically, everyone has the clue. Someone's got to have the idol by now, I think. Like, I don't know. That's pretty much the idol situation. So moving forward with just, like, strategic things. I met with Ryan today.
All right.
Hello.
Day after the challenge. I'm here with the winner.
Again.
Of course. Right now, in my eyes, I see it, the vote going two ways. One, either against me and I go home, or against Greg and he goes home.
Basically, this week, Greg and Ryan are going at each other. I don't know which one's the better choice at this point. I know most people are leaning towards keeping Ryan, getting rid of Greg. But my opinion, if we get rid of Ryan, then we still have that Greg-Allison relationship, and that protects me for another week, because everyone's going to be focusing on that, not on the fact that I've won two challenges, I've played an idol, all that kind of good stuff.
I don't know why we wouldn't want to go for Greg right now, and why you wouldn't want to get on board. He's literally been controlling the game since day one. Like, my tribe didn't even have to go to the first three tribal councils, and he's literally controlled the first three tribal councils. He's finished very close to first in the first challenge, won the second challenge, almost won the third challenge, and he's not received a single vote. Not one. If he ends up making it to the end, who would not vote for him?
The whole point of telling Greg that we should maybe flip on Ryan was to prevent Ryan from flipping on us first, but he kind of is smart enough to catch on that, like, he should be worried about that now.
I think we're both, like, smart enough to know that, like, this is our best chance to take one of each,
yeah.
One of, like, either me or him out.
I kind of want to argue that Ryan is smarter than Greg at this game. Greg is very smart, like, don't get me wrong. He makes a lot of really good decisions and moves, but I feel like Greg kind of, like, spews out information, and then Ryan's the one that comes and, like, analyzes everything, makes a plan out of it. But then we run into the fact that I think Greg or Allison has that advantage, so the lower numbers that we get, the stronger that advantage gets, because if it is like an extra vote or cancel out vote, like, I don't know, it matters. So
I'm pretty sure Steph's on board, and I don't think Greg would try and go to Steph and tell her to write me. So, like, I think she's on board with this, and then I was hoping to get you on board with this as well.
Just kidding, yeah.
And then I was thinking either Jake or Alex. I feel like right now is the time where we're both gonna be gunning for each other, and it's just about talking to everyone and just hoping that they land on your side of the fence.
Definitely a lot of factors to think about. I don't think that this should be just an easy wing it vote. I think that this decision will really carry forward in all of the following tribals and, like, how this game plays out towards the end. So we really need to think this one through. We'll see. Got a lot of thinking to do.
Hey.
Hello.
Basically, I just came from meeting with Ryan. Basically, his whole point of talking to me was, like, I know I can get Stephanie, and then he said he thinks he can get me. Like, just, he said I'm basically, like, I just have to pick a side. And then he was like, I just want to know, should I try to pull in Jake or Alex? And he was leaning towards Alex.
This coming week, I feel like I'm in a comfortable spot. Like, the two people who are, like, really scrambling is Ryan and Greg.
Do we know who Greg's going to try to get on his side? I'm assuming everybody,
too. I doubt he's going
to. Yeah.
Well, I mean, you, I think, would be, like, the bottom.
Yeah, right. He probably thinks I'm 100%
Ryan. Yeah.
I think that most people think that I'm with Ryan and Allison is with Greg, and then Jake, Autumn, and Alex are in the middle. From what I hear, Ryan thinks he has Autumn, Greg thinks he has Autumn, and then they're either going to try to get Jake or Alex on their side.
But I think as long as the four of us all vote the same way, it's guaranteed that it's not going to be one of us.
Right.
Greg or Ryan, either one of them can go home. Like, either way, it's not me, so I'm not too worried. I mean, I prefer Ryan to stay because I can trust him more, but if Greg stays, like, that's all right. I'll still be able to work with him and get out someone else next week that's not me. So hopefully everything goes according to plan and someone's going to get blindsided and it's not going to be me. So, go Bucks.
They have no idea, like, any of us are really connected. Like, I think that this group, like, you're going to be, like, honestly fine.
This is the first time I've been semi-excited for a tribal. I'm not that nervous this week, which could be a bad thing, but so far from everything I've heard from everybody, it's going to be between Ryan or Greg. Which is exciting because we have the opportunity to take out one of the most powerful players in the game this week.
Have we decided who we want to?
For me personally, like, my heart wants to get out Greg. Personally, I've been wanting to get out Greg since the first week. I tried getting Raphael and Autumn to vote with Khaki and I to get Greg out. Well, Allison really, but would have affected Greg. Didn't work out. That part of me really wants to vote out Greg, but if I'm thinking strategically, I want to get out Ryan, because I don't think Stephanie trusts him fully, but the fact that they've had a relationship is a little scary if we're going to go through this four. And I think that Greg and Allison are a much scarier duo, so I don't think any of us four would flip to join Greg and Allison if they were the ones that were left.
I just want to see one of them. It's just most important to me that one of them stays.
Yeah.
An opportunity is presenting itself for us to get one of them out. I would be
wrong. Yeah. I think even Greg and Ryan know that they're going for each other. The fact that they know this makes me a little bit nervous, because whatever they have, if they have anything, they will play it. And if they both play something, me, Jake, Autumn, and Stephanie, I'm working with her. Weird. If that happens, then we would just all vote for Allison.
Well, I was gonna say, regardless if Greg has an idol or Ryan has an idol, like, if one of them plays it, obviously the other will go home. If either of them have the envelope, and if it's like a steal a vote or block a vote, that won't matter. The only key thing is if they both have idols, which is a rare possibility, then we can just re-vote and all go for Allison.
I don't really enjoy working with Stephanie. I don't know. I just don't trust her. I do think she could be taking all the information we're saying and bringing it to Ryan. But, I mean, we're working together for now. Me and Jake and Autumn met all three together. And we really want Stephanie to think that she is running this group, because that's gonna let us trust her a little bit more, because why would she, like, mess things up with her own group that she's trying to run? It's awesome that four could be a majority now at this point. Like, that's really cool. Nobody really knows about it, hopefully, fingers crossed, unless Stephanie's telling Ryan, and then Ryan will be telling Greg, and Greg will be telling Allison, and you know. But hopefully this can kind of go undetected, but that's in a perfect world, and that's never gonna happen. We will just see.
Hola, hola.
Hey, hey. So pretty much Jake came in, and he was like, immediately he told me about the clue. I mean, he's like, he sat down and he's like, all right, I want to tell you about the clue.
During the challenge, Stephanie, Ryan, and I got the clue.
Right.
We decided, like, we would use it for ourselves tonight. It basically said victory bell.
And then the next thing that came out of the Jake conversation was, you know, I told him, I was like, look, I'm realistic enough to know that me and Ryan are both going to be targets, and so I would like to take Ryan out before I, you know, get taken out.
I talked to Allison this morning, and she had mentioned that she met with you, and uh-huh. that you guys were kind of both on board with voting for Ryan.
Yeah.
I didn't want to, like, push Ryan at first, because you guys have, like, been growing closer.
Right. You know, obviously I trust Ryan, but at the same mm-hmm. time, like, I don't trust him to the end, because he right. doesn't want to take me. That's kind of where I'm coming from, but I just wanted to, you know, make it clear that I'm not good with voting Ryan. I don't even need it to be Ryan, this vote. I just need it to not be me, and I know that this vote is kind of pitting Ryan and I against each other. So while I would like to keep Ryan around just because he's a cool guy, we get along well, we work together well, at the same time, I understand that I think a threat is going to be taken out this vote. And at that point, it's either me or him, because Autumn has immunity. So it's like, I'm trying to make sure that I have the numbers on my side to vote out Ryan.
100, like looking you in the eyes, 100% genuine, I'm good with voting Ryan.
Okay.
We've kind of put ourselves in this position a little bit. And that's not to discredit anybody else, but it seems like we've kind of put ourselves in this position where 7 is when a move needs to be made. And that's why I wanted immunity so bad, is because I knew it was going to happen this way, but didn't get it. And now I just got to kind of play it and see what happens.
We all know now at this point.
we know the two options.
Now we know, yes. It's going to be Greg or Ryan.
Where I'm at is I would rather keep you than Ryan, because I have worked with you for like since
beginning.
The very beginning, yeah.
In all honesty, like, if you're willing to put yourself out there and keep me with this vote, like, I have absolutely no reason to go against you.
Based on the past conversations, I would say you have a better chance of staying than Ryan. But
like I said, talk to whoever. I'm at the mercy of you guys. Mm-hmm. So it kind of comes down to like Jake and Alex to make this decision. Autumn too. I've got the security blanket of using the advantage if I need to. And it's not ideal that I use it at 7, but I'm still in the game. The other thing is too is that we have our idol. Allison and I do, and so if I decide, okay, I don't want to play the advantage, but then during tribal something gets kind of shaky because I can't play the advantage after tribal's already started, we can always play the idol, assuming that she would want to play it for me. So obviously if I play my stuff now, if I play my advantage now, I'm guaranteed 6, but then it's gone. So I kind of lose that leverage. If I don't play it now and I don't get voted out, then that's even more power for me because I made it through the toughest vote. But then on the other side, I could not play it, get voted out, and I look like an idiot. I don't know. It's going to be stressful. I mean, I'm not the most expressive person, obviously you guys have all seen it, but at the same time, like, I am very passionate about this game and I care a lot about, you know, playing the game and continuing to play the game. You know, my passion might not come out in the forms of being overly dramatic, but my passion shows up in the strategy and the thought that, you know, is kind of behind the scenes that you don't see on camera. I mean, you get the conversations and the confessionals, but all the time that I spend outside the game thinking about each and every scenario and, you know, what if I did this, what if I do this. It'll be too bad if this is my last couple days in the game, but you gotta feel confident and hope that I hear good news. And if I'm feeling like it's not good news, I've got my advantage, I'll play it and I'll be good. But it's gonna be a long couple days trying to figure out if I should or shouldn't.
Alright, so
hour left till tribal.
Yeah, this week my vote is, drumroll please, Greg. And I'm sure that doesn't surprise anyone because I'm not going to write my own name down.
I met with Jake on Friday and he was saying that, like, yeah, I've been wanting to get Greg gone for, like, since, like, week 2.
This week seems to be a feud of sorts between you and Greg.
It's going
to
be me versus him.
Greg. I can tell you for a fact that I have been trying to get Greg out since week 1. I wanted to get a group with Khaki, and we were going to get out Greg, and then no one did it, so I ended up voting Khaki. Like,
I'm 100% down to do this, honestly. And then I talked to Alex on Saturday, and she seemed like she was still contemplating a decision, but I think she was leaning towards Greg just because she sees that, like, he's been running the game forever.
They're... tribe went to tribal, the very first tribal, and he's controlled the game since then. No one, and he's received no votes. Not
ever?
A single vote ever. His name's never been written down
at
tribal. Yeah.
Hopefully the first time he gets votes,
yeah.
The last time he gets votes as well.
Yeah.
It was a nice battle this week. It was literally just me and Greg just meeting up with people and just, here's my argument, here's his argument, and then they're just going to have to try and figure out what way they want
to
go.
I talked to Jake on Friday, and it seemed like he was very in on voting Greg. Mm-hmm. And I talked to Alex yesterday, and she seemed that she was very down to vote Greg as well.
I feel like none of them are lying to me. Like, they have no reason to lie to me. So I'm pretty sure you're going to be safe.
It just sucks to vote out. Like, one of us are going to go home, and it's just going to suck because, like, I'm going to miss playing the game with Greg if he goes home, and I'm sure he's going to miss playing the game with me when I go home. But I feel like we have enough votes to get him to go home. I think Steph's on board with it, and I do really trust Stephanie, even though a lot of people don't. Like, I've been working with her since day one, so I really do trust her. I think Autumn's on board with it. I think Jake's on board with it. I met with Alex on Saturday, so hopefully she votes Greg.
I think I can trust everyone, but, like, if I end up going home, like, it makes sense. Like, I'm not going to be surprised.
right? It's me if I go home, but
I don't think it's you unless he was like able to persuade like Jake, Alex, or Autumn to like hop on his side.
So I feel like everyone is on board with it. I just feel like he's gonna have something up his sleeve that's just gonna screw me over. So like that minute where literally Greg goes, if you have a hidden immunity idol, now's the time to play it. What is it, 10 seconds? It's gonna be the longest 10 seconds of my life. Cause I know if he stands up, I am going home. I might as well stand up and grab the torch and just say, yeah, like hold it up, yeah, I'm gone. Greg, please don't have the hidden immunity idol. Please, please don't. Please. Please.
Hello? I want to bring in two members of your jury. Come on in. Kelly and Brooke voted out at the last tribal council. Brooke, how are you?
Oh, I'm fantastic. Get to have a nice, relaxing weekend in West Virginia. Didn't have to worry about the game. Just got back and now I get to watch all the fun drama.
Oh, good to have you back as well.
Thanks, Greg.
Awesome. So, again, one of the seven of you will become the third member of the jury and have your shot at being a sole survivor strike tonight. So, welcome back. I think this week was fun because it was your first really unique challenge. Autumn comes out on top in the endurance challenge. And Autumn, how are you feeling today?
I feel great. I think that this challenge was a big one to win. I think the merge is a big checkpoint, and then for me at least, final six is another big checkpoint that I wanted to make it to. It was kind of nice to like not have to worry about having to talk to everyone and freaking out, like wondering if my name's coming up. I think it would have been a lot different if I hadn't won this and someone else had, so.
Great. You stood out there beside Autumn for a long time. You guys went at it. It was fun to watch, but not having it tonight, do you feel one?
Oh, I'm very nervous. I'm very nervous. That's out there now. I feel very nervous.
So, Jake, on the flip side, first one out of the challenge, by choice.
Voluntary.
Right. Jake drops out of the challenge by choice when we offer a temptation. You take off the foil off the plate, and what is it?
Mashed potatoes.
It's a plate of mashed potatoes. So, I guess, are you confident enough in the conversations that you've had with everyone that this decision tonight will go your way?
I mean, everyone knows that this week's vote is between Greg and Ryan, if we're being 100% honest. So I'm not necessarily nervous, but I can't know for sure.
So I guess cat's out of the bag. Jake throws out Ryan and Greg as two targets for this week. So Greg, I'm going to ask you, what is your pitch to these guys to keep you? Because if it truly is between you two, what have you been saying this week to protect you?
I mean, it's no secret that Ryan and I have worked together in the past pretty closely, so we have pretty similar pros and cons. My main pitch was that Ryan has Steph, and I don't have, like, Ryan is my closest ally, he's got Steph, like, with him too, and so, like, he's got, if we get to six, he's got a third of the votes with him. So,
like, you two are fair, everyone knows we're a pair. I mean, we're on the same tribe, but that's what perceives.
And I could see how you think that from being on the other tribe originally, but in honesty, like, me and Greg have been working with originally, like, Jake and Mitch, and then Jake got swapped, and then so it's, you know, me and Greg and Mitch were still trying to work together, then obviously Mitch got sent home, and from there on out, like, we haven't had a connection as much as people think. So I do see how that's, like, the perception, and people have been, you know, saying, like, oh, you're a pawn, blah, blah, blah to me, and I know that, but, like, it's not really as strong as people.
Yeah, which I mean, but that's up to you guys to decide, because it is perception, but that's, I mean, she's had her own game, she's playing her own game, we just have played together. So, but that was my pitch, was that you're looking at a third of the votes behind you, or behind me, but if I'm staying, then I'm 1/6 of the votes.
So, Ryan, is it you or Greg tonight?
I definitely think it's either me or Greg tonight, and if he gets his pitch, I'll give you my pitch. My pitch is just that I feel like Greg's been in control of the game since, like, I only started playing the game after 3 weeks and because I didn't have to go to a tribal council. Like, he's controlled every single vote since day one. I feel like it's better if you're sitting next to me at the end than it would be to Greg. You'd have more of an opportunity.
So, Ryan brought up that I've had control of the votes, but, I mean, inherently, after the merge, votes get a little more complicated and a little more important. Because at the very beginning of the game,
I mean, we're all trying to feel each other out. So the first three votes, how much weight does that really carry in final tribal? I don't think a whole lot. I would say the first two or three votes after the merge carried way more weight than voting out Kaki, Raphael, Regan, you know? So that's just...
Socially, I'd say that we have pretty much the same game, but in challenges, I feel like Greg's been a much bigger threat in challenges, whether the first one he made it to the puzzle was pretty close to finishing. He won the second challenge, and then this last challenge, he finished right up the top, right next to Autumn. So it's definitely something that how many more times are we going to have the opportunity to for Greg to not rattle off the next six straight challenges right now.
Alice, you be quiet. How are you feeling right now?
I'm feeling okay. I mean, I was kind of, this is the first time I've ever been a tiny bit excited to come to trial because it has been fun to see the faces. I like both of you guys a lot. I know who I'm voting for and just trying not to freak out, I guess.
We had a fun discussion. I don't know where it broke up, but it broke open at some point. So, unless you guys have anything else that you want to say, Alex, it's time to vote.
I really don't want to. You know I don't want to, but it's either me or you, that's obvious. And if it's me, I'm gonna look like a fucking dumbass. So I'm really hoping it's you.
Obviously, I think you're a cool person, and I don't want to have to vote you out, but I'm gonna, because I'm obviously, as everybody called out, aligned with Greg.
We were writing our names down since the challenge ended, so best of luck. See what happens.
All right, guys. That was a good vote. If anybody has an intermediate idol and you would like to play, now would be the time to do so. Alright, once the votes are read, this is your final person voted out the SD the tribal council area immediately. I will read the votes. First vote is Ryan. Greg. One vote Ryan. One vote Greg. Ryan. Two votes Ryan. Greg. That's two votes Ryan. Two votes Greg. Greg. That's three votes Greg. Two votes Ryan. And the 10th person voted out, but survivor timing change, the third member of our jury is Greg. Greg, I'm sorry. Greg, your torch. Greg. Greg, try to smoke. Final six. I think this is a solemn end to this feud that was called out tonight. Ryan, congrats. Let's talk about the future. More and more of you will be joining the jury. And based on tonight's vote, I don't think anybody knows how this is going to end. So, with that being said, you guys can grab your stuff. We head on out.
Oh, I'm so stupid. All right, well, I had the advantage and felt a little risky. I thought that if I was able to hold on to it and get through this vote, then I would be able to have a really good shot at going Final Four. And so it was one of those high ceiling, low floor kind of things, and the floor killed me.
I think I'm the first person to ever write your name down at Tribal, so that's kind of an honor. I like you. I'm sorry that we have to do this. There was a decision to be made, and unfortunately you are on the wrong side of that decision, so...
I don't know. Good luck to them all. I mean, there's no bad blood. I guess Steph kind of hates me a little bit, but that's all right. But yep, it's all good. Just bummed, and I'm gonna look like an idiot in this episode, but that's all right.
I'm so sorry. I'm gonna say that you're the best player in this game, and I'm really, really sorry. And I'm probably gonna talk a lot more about you in my confessionals about how much I love you. Okay.
I think I played a pretty good game, and I think that's what got me out, is I just played a good game. And, you know, Ryan played a good game too, to his credit. It was him and I this vote. Yeah, I gotta live with it. It's all good.
It's been a long time coming, you and me, but don't really want to work with Ryan in the future. But I don't want you to win, so it's gotta be you. And also, you have been working with Allison. I'm sick of this.
Thanks to everybody who I played with. It was really fun, especially the post-merge people. I mean, that was intense. It was some of the most stressful moments of my life. It was exciting to be a part of, and I can't wait to see how the rest of it ends for sure. But yeah, that's all I got.